Now we're going to be talking about cancer incidence, or how often cancer is diagnosed and how often it kills people around the world. If you look at the leading causes of death worldwide in 2012, and this is when the last statistics were really available, you can see that heart disease continues to kill over 7 million people a year around the world, followed closely by stroke, as well as chronic obstructive pulmonary disease and pneumonia. Number five on this list is lung cancer, killing about 1.5 million people per year. This graph is somewhat misleading, however, because if you really look at the number of all cancers diagnosed globally, it's actually 14.1 million cancers diagnosed in 2012 worldwide. Importantly, more than half of these, 8 million, occurred in economically developing countries around the world. And very significantly, 8.2 million people died of cancer in 2012, making it the number one killer in the world overall and number one cause of death. The number of people expected to be diagnosed 15 years from now in 2030 is almost 22 million people. This is because as we actually eradicate diseases like pneumonia and malnutrition and chronic obstructive pulmonary disease and some of the diarrheal illnesses, people are expected to live much longer. As they live longer, more cancer will be diagnosed. So in 2030, we expect almost 22 million people to be diagnosed and 13 million people to die of cancer, despite the advances we'll be talking about in treatment throughout the course of later lectures. Overall, the most common cancers worldwide are lung cancer, accounting for 13% of all cancers diagnosed, or 1.8 million people. Breast cancer is diagnosed in 1.7 million women per year and account for about 12% of all cancers diagnosed. Colon cancer, 10% of all cancers diagnosed, 1.4 million people. Prostate cancer, 1.1 million men get diagnosed with prostate cancer every year. Stomach cancer, almost a million people are diagnosed yearly with stomach cancer. And liver cancer, almost 800,000 people are diagnosed with liver cancer. If you look at the causes of death in the United States, and here we have data from 2014, heart disease and cancer remain the number one and two killers by far compared to all of the other illnesses that afflict United States citizens. If you compare what kills people in the U.S. compared to around the world, you see a much lower incidence of respiratory disease, stroke, and pneumonia, and certainly diseases like malnutrition and diarrheal illnesses have been virtually wiped out in the United States. As we continue to improve our ability to treat heart disease, high cholesterol, hypertension, it is expected that cancer will become the number one killer in the United States. This ends our section on incidence of cancer. We've basically reviewed cancer facts around the globe, as well as in the U.S. And in the next section, we will talk about the common cancers.